Welcome, my friends. Today we will be answering probability questions related to contingency tables. A contingency table is just a table that shows the distribution of one variable in the columns and a second variable in the rows. For example, consider this contingency table showing millennial and baby boomers' response to the question, "Do you like pineapple on pizza?" The two variables are the response, either dislike, neutral, or like, and the generation, millennial or baby boomer. We can see from the table that there are 600 millennials and 400 baby boomers. These two numbers add up to the total number of people surveyed, which is 1,000. 620 respondents disliked pineapple on pizza, 250 were neutral, and 130 like pineapple on pizza. These three numbers also add up to 1,000. Any of the cells inside the boxed region represent intersections of levels of the two variables. So, for example, this cell means that there were 360 millennials surveyed who dislike pineapple on pizza. This cell means there were 40 baby boomers surveyed who like pineapple on pizza. Don't take the numbers in the table too seriously, as I've made them up. To make the probability statements cleaner, I have labeled each of the events with a capital letter. Now we are ready to use this contingency table to answer some probability questions. For example, what is the probability that an individual from the survey is a millennial? Well, if we look at our table, we see that there are 600 millennials out of the total of 1,000 individuals surveyed. So 600 out of 1,000 is equal to 0.6. So that is the probability that an individual from the survey is a millennial. How about the probability an individual from the survey is a baby boomer and neutral on the question of if they like pineapple on pizza? The probability statement is the probability of B and N. For AND probabilities in the contingency tables, we find the intersection of the two events, being a baby boomer and being neutral on the question. 100 out of the 1,000 surveyed are baby boomers neutral on the question, which simplifies to 0.1. How about the probability someone from the survey is either neutral or likes pineapple on pizza? This is an OR type probability, meaning we must ask the question whether or not the two events are mutually exclusive. Remember that two events are mutually exclusive if they cannot happen at the same time. An individual cannot be both neutral and like pineapple on pizza at the same time, so therefore these two events are mutually exclusive, meaning that we can use the addition rule for mutually exclusive events. Applied to the letters N and L, the addition rule becomes the probability of N or L is equal to the probability of N plus the probability of L. The probability of the first event, neutral, is the total number of individuals who answered neutral, 250, out of the 1,000 individuals surveyed. And the probability of the second event, liking pineapple on pizza, is the total number of individuals who like pineapple on pizza, 130, out of the total of 1,000. Adding these two values together gives us 380 out of 1,000, or 0.38. Next, what is the probability an individual from the survey is a millennial or dislikes pineapple on pizza? Again, we have an OR probability, so we need to check whether or not the events are mutually exclusive. Are being a millennial and disliking pineapple on pizza mutually exclusive? No. An individual can both be a millennial and dislike pineapple on pizza, so we need to use the general addition rule and not the one for mutually exclusive events. This translates to the probability of M plus the probability of D minus the probability of M and D when applied to our events. The probability of M is 600 out of 1,000, the probability of D is 620 out of 1,000, and the probability of M and D is 360 out of 1,000. This gives us 860 out of 1,000, or a 0.86 probability that an individual surveyed is a millennial or dislikes pineapple on pizza. We can also ask conditional probabilities from a contingency table. For example, what is the probability of an individual from the survey liking pineapple on pizza given that they are a baby boomer? This translates into the probability of L given B. We find this by first finding the intersection of L and B, the number of baby boomers who like pineapple on pizza. we can see here that the intersection is 40. We take this value and divide not by the grand total of 1,000 like we have in the other parts, but by the total number of baby boomers, since our event is conditioned on baby boomers. Since there were 400 baby boomers surveyed, we must divide 40 by 400. 40 divided by 400 is equal to 0.1. The biggest mistake students make on conditional probabilities using contingency tables is dividing by the grand total instead of the total for the conditioned event, so make sure to not make that mistake. We can also prove independence using a contingency table. For example, are the events liking pineapple on pizza and being a baby boomer independent? Remember that there are three ways to prove independence. Typically, the first or second way is easier if you are working with a contingency table. In this case, the events L and B are independent if the probability of L given B is equal to the probability of L. We already found the probability of an individual liking pineapple on pizza, given they are a baby boomer in the last question, which is 0.1. Is this the same as the probability that someone likes pineapple on pizza in general? Well, the probability of someone liking pineapple on pizza from the survey is the 130 total individuals who like pineapple on pizza out of the 1,000 surveyed, which equals 0.13. This is not the same as 0.1, so therefore the events liking pineapple on pizza and being a baby boomer are not independent. Alright, my friends, we have finished our example of probabilities using contingency tables. We will be exploring many more fun and exciting statistical topics that you won't want to miss. So make sure to check out our other videos.